We're going to go back out to the Coliseum now to Al Michaels coming up the final in the women's 400-meter hurdles. Okay, Al.
All right, Jim, you know, I was listening to you talking about Zola Budd, and we didn't even have time before talking about all the things that are going on here tonight. In addition to what we told you before, Mary Decker's going to run tonight, and Carol Lewis will attempt to qualify in the long jump, so it's going to be a sensational evening at the Coliseum. As we look at the field now for the women's 400-meter hurdle final, you saw Anne-Louise Scoogland in one. There is Cristina Cojocaru of Romania in two. Scoogland is probably the lady to beat. Noal El Moutwakil from Morocco, who goes to Iowa State, is in three. Sandra Farmer from Jamaica. She attends Cal State LA, so she's basically running at home and representing Jamaica. P.T. Usha is a lady that some people think could win this race from India in lane five. 55.54 her time in the semis. Debbie Flintoff in lane 6 from Australia. Tuija Helander of Finland will be in lane 7. And then the only American to qualify, Judy Brown, is running outside in lane 8. I'm joined for the commentary now by Ronaldo Nehemiah, world record holder in the men's 110-meter hurdles. What about running in lane 8 for Brown?
Well, I think, Al, our better hurdlers in this race haven't been lucky in the lane assignment. As you said, Anne-Louise Scoogland, who has bettered the Olympic standard in this race, has drawn lane 1. And she's a fast starter. She could exert too much energy on the tight turns in this race, and it could hurt her coming down the home stretch. As you said, Judy Brown, she's in lane 8. She's our American record holder. She's known as a slow starter. And now that she's on the outside lane, she can't see anyone. And I would expect that she's going to be behind the first half of the race, and she's going to really have to press in the last 5 hurdles of this race.
What about somebody like Usha or somebody else? Do you like anybody else's chances here?
Like you said, Usha, she ran a surprising win in that semifinal at that 55-54. She's in a great spot. She can see everyone. She can run off everyone else's pace.
Really unheard of when she showed up in Los Angeles. 20 years old. The Asian continental record holder, but got no pre-Olympic publicity, really. And here she is with a chance to perhaps win the gold. We'll find out. They're really spread out in this field as far as the favorites are concerned, with Scoogland in one and Brown in 8 and then Usha in the middle. Once around the track, they stay in their lanes all the way. Women's 400-meter hurdles. Judy Brown, Michigan State graduate, living and training now in Eugene, Oregon.
Set.
It's a fair start with Brown in lane 8, and Flintoff has pulled up in lane 6, and it's also a false start. And it could be the clicking of the photographers. That it's possible. All the photographers are down in that area, as you can see. Remember the other night, Edwin Moses was not charged with a false start because of all of the clicking cameras. So we'll wait and see. We'll get the official word if we can as to whether or not somebody has been charged indeed with a false start.
Alan, that could be a great distraction. They are so close on the track. They're right on the track, and there are hundreds of them right there, and that clicking adds up to an insurmountable noise, and total concentration is needed in this race, especially with Judy Brown on the outside lane. She's right there on top of the photographers.
Flintoff was the first to hear the false start. She pulled up. Everybody else kept on going for 3 or 4 more strides. No flag. We've seen no flag. That means that they have probably attributed to, and we just talked about Edwin Moses. There he is watching, along with his wife, the ladies run the race that he's really made very famous. He said the other night this was one of the more non-glamorous races for years, and then that man himself just elevated it to a whole other state. Again, Brown in 8. Scoogland in lane 1. And among the others, El Moutwakil in 3. Usha in 5.
Set.
This time, a fair start. And they're just about even as they go to the first hurdle, with Helander looking good in lane 7. And also El Moutwakil looking very strong at the outset here in lane 3, Skeets.
In past races, Al Moutwakil, she's only 5'3". She's a gutsy runner, and because she's so short, she really explodes in this first 200. She really sets the pace.
Here she comes into your picture. That is El Moutwakil from Iowa State, representing Morocco in lane 3. Judy Brown in lane 8 in decent shape. Here comes Scoogland now making her move, but it's El Moutwakil who has the lead as they begin to straighten out. Nawal El Moutwakil in lane three is out in front. Skoglund is second. Brown is fifth at the moment. El Moutwakil with one more hurdle to go. She chopped her stride, but still has plenty left, and she's going to win it. And here comes Brown up on the outside to take the silver medal and a blanket finish for third. I think it might have been Kojikaru of Romania. There's an upset.
Al, fantastic race by El Moutwakil. We didn't really think that she could have the strength and stamina because she's so short in stature, but she went out so fast, and that's another key to running this race. If you can go out fast, and a lot of ladies like to pace themselves off the front runners, but if you get too far in front of them, they can't come back. And as we said, Judy Brown, who has that tremendous final four or five hurdles, she didn't look like she was going to be a contender the last three hurdles. She came on strong. She is exceptionally strong in that last straightaway.
54.62, that is a new Olympic record. 54.62, Brown coming on very strong, as you say. Nawal El Moutwakil from Morocco, she's the African record holder. She also attends Iowa State University. She won the NCAA championships this year. 55.37 was her personal record coming in, and she has eclipsed that by almost 7/10 of a second. Very close to an American record, 54.62.
And now
for Judy Brown, close to an American record for Judy.
In a relatively new event here in the Olympic Games, they first started out running 60 seconds. Now they are down to running 54. The world record down in 53. So in a short-lived event, it's going to really drop.
Watch Judy Brown now in lane 8 on the outside. Her charge for second.
As we said, Judy Brown was in lane 8, and she really couldn't see anybody until she got on the straightaway. And this is where she makes most of her time in this race. She never gives up. She's running strong. She's very tall, very agile. Never gives up. Everyone else, I said, as Skoglund in lane 1 probably expended too much energy running the tight turn, and Judy Brown just puts her head down. And the race is never over until you cross the finish line. Not looking at anyone. She's just giving it all she has. And this is what it takes to win a medal at the Olympic Games.
Look at that battle for third. It's clear that Brown wins the silver, and then we suspected that the Romanian, and when we look at the replay, I'll stick by that in lane three, at least for the moment I will, in lane two, Kojikaru. Also in lane five, that's Yusha of India. And as you can see, Skoglund appears to have finished fifth. But there's no question who won it and who finished second. Judy Brown from East Lansing, Michigan, has won the silver. Nawal El Moutwakil of Morocco, the gold at the Coliseum.